Hello everybody, this is Xavier from NGN, and this is a little weapon guide for The Last Stand 2 to show you a bit about the weapons and basically which weapons should you bring into battle for the night. Well, as you see, it's day 49. It doesn't really matter if you pass the 40-day mark, but you won't get the special ending at the end, which isn't so special, really. But yeah, I basically searched this game left and right. Supplies like there's no tomorrow, and sadly I lost a survivor and I can't get him back. So I have my barricade ready to be repaired, and alrighty. Yeah. Alright, basically I'm pretty sure every gun here. If there's any missing, I'd like to know. Bottom line, take your RPG. They say that it has a slow reload time. Are you kidding me? This minigun right here has a much slower reload time. But yeah, bottom line, these are the two best weapons in the game. Actually, I don't even use this, so I give it to my survivor. It sucks that you can't give rocket launcher, hand grenades, chainsaw, or compound bow to the survivors. I find that pretty crappy. But whatever. So I put my hand grenades as backup, but I never use them, so I'm just going to go with something like an Uzi or whatnot. And shotguns are always good in the hands of survivors. I've learned that over time, so sawn off and whatnot, and of course the minigun. So I got RPG, Uzi for backup. I'm probably only going to be using the RPG because it has great damage. Traps, well, they come convenient every now and then. Just place bear traps here in case. Landmines in case. You know, it's normal procedure. Alrighty. These come in handy, but basically I got an RPG, so that does a job on every shot. Alrighty.
Let's do this! Yeah!
Oh yeah, you'll see how the RPG just does crazy damage. And see, that wasn't too fast, too slow of a reload time. Look at that, it's cleared a whole group with one shot. Was that so hard? And then with the landmines, they help out by the accidental chip on it, makes a little explosion. And barricade, so that covers that. But yeah, as you see, RPG should do the trick. You don't need much more, really. Survivors take out a small group at a time. I mean, they do help in the long run, if you're asking. See, look at that. Took out a whole group with just one shot. That is damage, my friends. He's caught in the bear trap.
The bear cat.
Sorry, stuck in my head. People with no lives, you know how it is. Well, people like me, but I don't think so. That in a short amount of time. There was a lot of zombies, but as you see, with the RPG, you clear yourself very fast. And if we go to map wise, as you can see, I took the long way to go to every town just so I can collect every weapon. But it all depends by what type of weapon you favor. I weapon single shot weapons like compound bow, hunting rifle, RPG. So I just go to Whistler's Grove. I skip Claysburg, so all there is there is the Uzi and whatnot. Too bad you can't just go to Jonestown. You have to go to Aspenwood where you get the hunting rifle. But I never like traveling to that town because there seems to be a lot of zombies and it's a pain in the ass. So I try and get out of there as soon as I can and hit the Jonestown. From there you get your AK, hand grenades, whatnot. And I'd suggest going straight to Union City, but if you want those last few weapons just to own, well, I'd say go to Fort Tryon and get your RPG and minigun. But, so that's not really a guide, but gives you a good idea of how the game works, really. And yeah, all right. I don't have much to say. www.ngvids.co.nr. Check it.